We are starting a new series about one of my favorite things in life, pizza. And the series is called Pizza Makes You Fat. Pizza makes you fat. See, here's the thing. Here's the thing, Risen. If you can't control your pizza, you can't control your life, okay? If you can't control your pizza, you'll get fat. If you can't control how much pizza you eat, you will get fat and you will die. Pizza makes you fat. Over the next four weeks, we want to talk to you guys all about self-control. So you can eat pizza, but you got to eat it a little bit at a time. Enjoy it a little bit here, a little bit there. Well, you guys can eat it basically all the time. I can only eat it every so often because my metabolism is not as good as yours, and it slows down. Preach, all the old people, preach. I'm not even old. My gosh. So say this with me. Tonight I'm going to talk to you guys about your words. So say this after me. If you can't control your words, you can't control your life. Say it with me one more time. If you can't control your words, you can't control your life. That's what we're talking about tonight. Is that cool? I'm going to read a scripture. Actually, you know what I want you to do? Everybody just get on your feet for a sec. Everybody's on your feet. Everybody in the room. If you're willing, if you're able, even if you're not willing but you're able, come on, stand up. Or else we'll practice that whole slap the person around you thing. Yeah, everybody's like, oh, better stand up. What I want to do is we're going to put a scripture on the side screen, and what I want to read it all together. It's a short one. It's easy. So let's put it on the side screen, and we'll read this together. Look, there's a camera right here. This is awkward. Ready? 2 Timothy 1:7. 3, 2, 1. For God has not given us a spirit of fear and timidity, but power, love, and self-discipline. One more time. God has not given us a spirit of fear and timidity, but of power, love, and self-discipline. God, thank you so much for tonight, Lord. Thank you that we have the opportunity to be here at Risen, getting ready to go out for Risen Camp. Lord, speak tonight to the students in this building. Speak tonight to everyone who's in here, Lord. Speak to everyone who's watching online. May all this go to your glory and your honor. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. Sit down. Get some energy out of you guys. Here's how tonight's going to be successful, okay? When I need you to talk, what do? You talk. When I don't need you to talk, don't talk. Okay, that's how tonight's going to be the most successful, okay? So when I need you, I need you. Okay. Oh, kick the water bottle. Risen Camp's just around the corner. You know that. We've been talking about it. Risen Camp registration open. Merch is out. So I've been thinking about Risen Camp for, well, weeks now. I'm just going to move this because I want to. I've been thinking about Risen Camp for weeks now, and I'm not necessarily a part of a team anymore. I cheer for all teams, or I pick my favorite one based on who's in it, and then I cheer for them. But I wasn't always this way, okay? I was at one point part of the unicorns, okay? The blue unicorns. Relax. All you unicorns out there, this is a different era. This is a different time. The unicorns today are great. Don't get me wrong. You guys are awesome. But I'm telling you, the unicorns of late, man, they were like, woo. We were unbeatable. We were next to Wayne Gretzky. And we were, why are you laughing? And we were next to Michael Jordan or LeBron, depending on Michael Jordan. We were up with the greats, okay? The unicorns, the blue unicorns. My gosh, we came from nothing to greatness, man. I tell you, we for four years straight, I went home a champion from Risen Camp. 4 years straight, blue team, unicorns, man. There's a piece of my heart. Hashtag bleed blue. Unicorns, man. We were unstoppable. Nobody could stop us. We got to a point where we were winning every year that we actually had to scrap the name unicorns because people hated us. And we've brought it back, obviously, and I'm secretly cheering for the unicorns this year because I'm hoping that we can bring back the glory days of the... Hello! So I love the unicorns, but I remember one time we were playing a game. It's called Fire and Rain. You'll probably play it this year. It's a really fun game. And the whole idea is at the end of the time limit, you have the biggest fire. Everybody has the opportunity to build a fire, and everybody has the opportunity to get water balloons to put somebody else's fire out. Now, we were building a fire. We were winning because we're the unicorns. And... I started talking to a few other teams, okay? And you'll learn as you go to Risen Camp, this kind of stuff happens, okay? You don't necessarily make an alliance because that's too far, but you make an agreement. And so I had made an agreement with two of the other teams, the yellow team and the green team. I had made this agreement that if you don't go for me, I won't go after you. I took their word. I said, yes, I won't go for you. You won't go for, okay, I won't go for you. You won't go for him. So we had this agreement. So at the end of the day, it was really a 3-on-1 kind of thing. We could only attack the red team. Now, over the megaphone, there's 5 minutes remaining. Woo, 5 minutes remaining. And I'm standing there like, hey, get the marshmallows ready. Get them s'mores mix out. We's about to have a fire. And I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great. I think our team's played a great game. I thought that this agreement was the greatest thing of all time. I thought that I was a genius because I'd taken these guys' word. And they said, yeah, untouchable, man. You're untouchable. Little did I know, this same agreement was being made between yellow, green, and red. The same agreement of, I won't go for you if you don't go for me. So, 5 minutes remaining in the game. Games team goes over the megaphone.
There's 5 minutes remaining.
I'm sitting there, chilling, got my s'mores mix out, hanging out with the team, high-fiving, high-fiving. All of a sudden, I look down. I'm kind of on this hill, just where we are in the camp. I'm on this hill, and I look down, and there's a lot of people running at my team. It's not just the red team. It's the red team, it's the yellow team, and it's the green team. Because they had made the same agreement. Now, I'm standing there like, what am I supposed to do? I can't take it. It's a 3-on-1, but I thought it was a 3-on-1 against them. It's a 3-on-1 against me. And I was upset. I was mad. I was going to say something that I shouldn't say. I had my underwear in a knot. Thus, I was going to... I feel awkward now. I don't know why I said that. I feel awkward now. But I trusted them. I took their word, and then they turned on me, and I got played. Don't worry, though. We still won that year. We just didn't win that game. It's all good, though. We still won that year. So, but I realized in that moment there's power to your words. There's power to what you speak, because I believed them. When they told me with their words, they could be trusted. I believed them when they told me that I was all good and that they wouldn't come after me when really I got played. See, we got one of the best pastors in the world at our church, okay? Pastor Dennis is amazing. See, what you're speaking is what you're living. Okay, what you're speaking, Pastor D said it like this. He said, the quality of your life is determined by what is coming out of your mouth. The quality of your life is determined by what is coming out of your mouth. Proverbs 18:21, we're going to land here for tonight. Proverbs 18:21 says, the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. What you are saying is what you are living. Or the quality of your life is determined by what is coming out of your mouth. See, if you're speaking life, you'll live out life. Now that sounds weird, but I'm not talking like heartbeat, brains working, oxygen and lungs. I'm talking like in relationships, in your personal life, in your schools. I guess it's on summer, but you know what I mean. But I'm saying if you're speaking life into your relationships, out of those relationships, you'll gain life. But on the flip side, if you're speaking death, you will get death. Proverbs 18:21 can be one of the most encouraging verses, or it can be one of the most challenging verses. Because if you're speaking good, if you're speaking life already, it's encouraging. Because it's saying, if you keep speaking that way, you'll keep getting what you're getting. And you're probably happy with that. On the flip side, it can be most challenging. Because if you're not speaking life, and if you're speaking death, you're going to reap the death. You're going to get out of it that death. So it's challenging because I know that if I'm speaking death, if I'm speaking poorly, I'm challenged to change. See, I want to be somebody in my life that has control over my words. I want to be somebody, and I want you guys to be people that can control your words, because your words are the pavement to your future. What you're speaking today is setting up your tomorrow. See, sometimes in life we want to blame everything on situations or on circumstances or on other people, when sometimes you're in the place you're in today because of how you've been talking. We talk a lot. We talk a lot. I looked it up. Where's all the dudes in here tonight? Where's all the guys? Show me a hand. Give me like a woo, whatever you want to do. Make a noise. I don't know why that's the thing. Like, why do girls get to cheer and we have to go woo? It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense to me. I don't appreciate it. We have to bark. You get to cheer. I got my main man up here. I'm just wondering, if you were to guess how many words you speak in a day, how many would you guess?
5,000.
5,000. 5,000 words. 5,000 words, huh? Okay. 5,000. What I looked up and I found is that guys, I'm going to write a G. Oh, G. Girl starts with G too. All right, guys. Guys speak 7,000 words. 7,000 words. That's a lot. That's a lot. It's more than 5,000. It's less than 8,000. That's just math. That's got nothing to do with what I'm talking about tonight. That's just math. I'm just helping you guys. 7,000's here. 8,000's here. Girls! Where's a girl? Where's a girl? Where's a girl? How many words do you think women, on average, speak per day?
9,000.
9,000. Okay. So you recognize that women talk a lot, right? Right? Guys speak 7. Girls speak 9. Girls, my gosh, you guys can talk. What I looked up, where it told me guys speak 7,000, it told me that girls speak 20,000 words a day. My gosh, that's almost 3 times as much. Like, holy smokes. So, on average, if we were to just pick a number to work with tonight, work with me, okay? On average, that means that a human who speaks 13,500 words per day. 13,500 words per day. That's a lot of words, wouldn't you say? I looked up how much I wrote on my message out, and it's not even 2,000 words. So I'm up here talking, and I'm being purposeful with my talking. It's not even 2,000. But throughout my entire day, I could speak 13,000. I'm a talker, too, so you guarantee I'm speaking 13,500. Guarantee it. I might even be 20,000. I'm with you girls. I talk too much. No, I don't. Yeah, I do. 13,500 words per day. That's a lot of words, wouldn't you say? Would you say that's a lot of words? That's a lot of words. Now, I looked up how many negative words. I couldn't find negative words. I found negative thoughts. But really, what you're thinking is what you're saying, and what you're saying is what you're thinking. So I looked up how many negative thoughts, and get this, 80% of our thoughts are negative.
What?
80%. So if you do the math, and I have, you're welcome. That means that if 80% of our words are negative, we are speaking 10,800 negative words per day.
Wow.
10,800 negative. We only speak 13,500 and 10,800 are negative. So 10,800 times a day, you're speaking something negative into existence. 10,800 times a day, you are speaking something negative into your life. 10,800 times a day, you're hurting yourself. 10,800 times a day, you're sabotaging your future. 10,800 times a day, you're moving your life in the wrong direction, and so am I. That's too much. 10,800 words are being spoken that are negative. Wow. That is too much. 10,800 times. Man, Rizzi, your purpose is too big. Your calling from God is too big to be speaking like that. You have too bright of a future to be speaking like that. You are far too valuable to be speaking like that. Your future is too precious to be speaking like that. We gotta stop. Something's gotta change. Proverbs 18, let's go back to it. Is it still up there? Proverbs 18, 21. The tongue has the power of life and death. And this says this, and those who love it will eat its fruit. It's a weird thing. It's a weird thing to, like, you guys are like, what are you talking about? I get the first part, but why are we talking about fruit? It's basically saying that your words are guiding you somewhere. What you're speaking is what you are living. What you're speaking is what you are living. See, we have a choice. We have a choice because we can speak in any sort of situation. I know that a lot of crappy stuff happens to you. I know that a lot of stuff comes at you. I know that you're not in control of a situation or a circumstance all the time, but you are always in control of the choice that you make on how to deal with it. You're always in control of how you go through that situation. Not necessarily what happened to you, but how you handle it, you have a choice. Because you can go through any situation. You can choose joy and speak joy, or you can go anger and speak anger. You can speak life, you can speak death. You can speak love, you can speak hate. You can speak patience, or you can speak complaining. But it's your choice. It's your choice. You see, if you're constantly saying, I'm ugly, if you're constantly saying, I'm stupid, if you're constantly saying, I'm worthless, if you're constantly saying, I'm unlovable, if you're constantly saying, I'm a worrier or I'm a failure, guess where you're going to land? You're going to land there. You're going to be in this perpetual state of brokenness at all times because you're speaking that into existence. But if you just change the way you speak, I believe you can change your life. If you begin to speak like this, you say, I'm not ugly. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. If you begin to say, I'm not stupid. I'm more than a conqueror through him who loves me. I'm not worthless. God sent his one and only son so I could be saved. I'm not unlovable. I am loved by God Almighty. I'm not a warrior. I can cast all my cares onto God because God cares about me. I am not a failure because I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. What you're talking, what you're speaking is what you're living. What you're speaking is bringing life or death into your families, into your friends, and into your life. Just want to do something real quick. Where's Heidi and Sierra? Come on up here, guys. Heidi and Sierra. I've asked them. That was a great shout out. Hey, guys. Come on up. Come on up here. Come on up here. Here's what I'm going to, I want to illustrate to you guys kind of, Christine's going to play piano too. She's not like, I want to come. Sit down. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding, Christine. You can start whenever you want. I'm sorry. You can play the beautiful piano. Whoa, that was loud. Just do the pads for now. Just the pads for now. There we go. That's perfect. I want to illustrate to you guys what the power of your words can do. So what I'm going to get Heidi and Sarah, I've asked them both individually to prepare the song. You know the song Rise Up? It's amazing. It's powerful. It's great. So what they're going to do is I'm going to ask them to leave. You guys can leave. I know you just asked them up here, but we're going to talk. They can't hear this part. So you guys head out. You just plug your ears, yell at each other if you have to so you can't hear what we're talking about, okay? Lucas is going to make sure they can't hear. All right, Risen. Door shut. Here's what we're going to do. I've asked Heidi and Sierra to prepare the same song. They're both going to come up here, and individually, they're going to sing Rise Up. And Heidi's going to go first, okay? Heidi's going to go first. And when Heidi is done, I want you guys to lose it. Go crazy. Stand up on your feet, clap, scream, yell, celebrate how amazing Heidi did, okay? Can we do that? Can we just do that for me? Then when Sierra comes up, she's going to sing the same song in a similar fashion. And what I want you to do is absolutely nothing. Don't clap. Listen, don't clap. Don't clap. She's not insecure. It's fine. Don't clap. Don't scream. Don't stand. Actually, the best thing you can do is cross your arms like this and give like a face. But I don't want you to make a single noise. So when Heidi, yeah, when Sierra, and we're going to watch their facial expression and how they're feeling. Lucas, can you hear me? Bring him in here. Can we do this, Risen? Can we do this? All right. Good. Bring him up. Bring him out. It's hard to... Maybe not. Maybe I won't go there either. Dang. It's an old song. Y'all don't even know it anyways. Come on up here, guys. Come on up here. Come on, give it up for these two as they come. Come on up. Do you guys have any idea what you're doing besides singing? Have we talked about this before? A little bit, but you're nervous. You're nervous? I can tell. Okay, stage is yours, Heidi. Take it away. Go for it.
Arise like the day, arise unafraid, arise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And arise up, high like the waves, arise up, in spite of the ache, arise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, and no rise up, no rise up, oh rise unafraid, oh rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. In spite of the ache, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again.
Wow. Wow. All right, y'all sit down. Y'all sit down. Sierra, come on, take the...
I'll rise like the day, I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up, rise like the waves, I'll rise up, in spite of the ache, I'll rise up, and I'll do it.
Heidi, can you come up here for a second? Heidi, how are you feeling right now? How are you feeling? You're still nervous? You're feeling good, though? When they just cheered there, you got a little smile on, kind of didn't want to make eye contact. Like, you're feeling pretty good right now, aren't you? Sierra, how about you?
Like poo.
What you're speaking has power risen. When we freak out for Heidi, you can literally watch Heidi change. You can watch her facial expression change. You can watch the passion in what she's doing change. And the same can be said about Sierra. When no one cheered at the same time we cheered for Heidi, I watched her go like, oh, why am I up here? Why aren't they cheering the same way? Your words make a difference. What you're speaking makes a difference. You guys can sit up. Give it up for Sierra. can't control your words, you can't control your life. If we can't control our words, whatever life throws at us is how we'll live. Whatever the situations come, whatever the status quo says we should be talking, though, the way that we go through life, the world's way, the media's way, maybe your parents' way. If we go through life and we don't control our words, we cannot control our life. What you are speaking is what you are living. Your words make a difference. Your words make a difference to them, and it makes even more of a difference to yourself. If you're always speaking negative about yourself, I can promise you one thing, you will never see yourself as anything but negative. Just recently, I'd say a month and a half ago, I was in a pretty dark place as far as dark places go. Not like physically, like in my mind, in myself, and I was not happy. I was angry all the time. You could talk to my wife if you want to. Don't do that. Don't actually do that. That's weird. Don't do that. But I was in a pretty dark place. And what I noticed looking back is that every time I'd open my mouth, something negative was coming out. I would be working and negativity. I'd be around my friends, negativity. I'd be texting, negativity. I'd see somebody's Instagram post where they're doing something great for themselves or their family or their life, whatever. And I'd be like, that's stupid. I'm negative, 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 negative. And I was stuck in a rut of negativity. Then Pastor Dennis preached the message where he said the quality of your life is coming out of the words you're speaking or whatever he said. And I was like, oh my gosh. And I began to rethink my words. I began to rethink how I'm talking. I began to rethink relationships. I began to rethink that if I'm in a tough situation, man, maybe I can just speak different and something different will come out of it. And today I'm in a way different place than I was a month ago. Praise God. The words you're speaking make a difference. See, some of you guys tonight, well, I'm going to close with this. We're going to pray and then we're going to be done. Words are powerful. Check this out. It says in Romans 10, verse 9 and 10, it says, if you say that Jesus is Lord and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. If you declare with your mouth, it says, for it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. Some of you tonight, the best thing that you could do for your life tonight is declare Jesus as Lord. Some of you tonight have been coming to Risen week after week after week, and you've been hearing about Jesus every week. You've been in this moment where the speaker's about to give you an opportunity to give your life to Christ, and you've just not done it. But you know in your heart you need to. Jesus Christ came to this earth and died a sinless man so that us sinners could be saved by his grace. And this scripture is telling us that if we just declare with our mouth that he's Lord, we're saved. What does that mean? We're forgiven. Forgiven from what? Everything. Any sin you've committed to this point, any sin that you're committing right now, any sin you commit later on in your life, you're forgiven. Bible says you become a new creation, a new person when Jesus comes into your life. And I think that summer of 17 is the greatest opportunity, the greatest time is right now to confess Jesus as your Lord and be saved. Why wait till camp? Why wait till camp? Let's do it right here. Let's do it right now. Let's close our eyes. Let's bow our head. If you've been coming to Risen, maybe God's working on your heart right here, right now. Maybe it's your first time out tonight. Maybe you're watching online at home. Maybe you're watching and you're not even a student at home. I don't know. But you know that tonight's the night where you need to make Jesus Christ the Lord and Savior of your life. I want to pray with you guys. You know who you are. In your heart right now, something's happening. In your stomach right now, something's happening. In your body, something's happening. You know in your mind, tonight's my night. I need to make Jesus Christ the Lord and my Savior of my life. So what we're going to do is I want to pray this prayer with everyone in this room. And then on the count of three, after we pray, what I want you to do is slip your hand up if you're making that decision tonight. And then we're going to go wild. We're going to go nuts. We're going to celebrate you. Let's pray this after me. Say, Jesus, Thank you so much that you came and you paid for my sins. Today I declare, today I say with my mouth that you are my Lord. You are my Savior. Today I turn away from all the sin and all the wrongdoing, and I turn towards you in Jesus' name. Come on the count of three. If you prayed that prayer with me tonight, if you prayed that prayer and it's your night, summer 17 is your time. On the count of three, you slip your hand up. The rest of the room, we're going wild. Are we ready? 1, 2, 3. Stick your hands up. Stick your hands up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.